is Brent Gay, and I retired as a machine tender on paper machines at the Androscoggin. Started at the Otis, but retired from the Androscoggin. Machine tender is on the what's called the wet end of the paper machine, which is usually started on the other end and worked your way up through the job. Machine tender is the top job on the machine. That's where it first comes out as water and stock and starting to be formed. When I started up there, well, in 65 when the mill was built, and it was pretty impressive at the time. I mean, at the Otis, the machines were small, and well, it was impressive as a young fella, but when I get up there and I looked at the size of these machines, I got wondering what I got myself into. These were 2.5 times as big and high, but it was hard in the beginning, but as the jobs got better and better, and we learned, it was interesting. I enjoyed it for a long time, the job. I mean, it was a challenge, but then during the strike, that changed my attitude a little bit, but I still liked my job. It was a challenge. I thought I was good at it, so. My father worked at Otis, but not on paper machines. He worked in the groundwood department and that stuff most all of his life, I guess. And for us, that was the end to be a good job. I mean, if you gonna stay in the area and work, at mill was the place to be if you want to make a decent living. And all the father and them, they worked two jobs, most everybody did back then, but still it was the best paying jobs around. And the biggest thing was, I guess, in Otis years ago, it used to be business would drop off in the winter, it'd be layoffs. And you'd have to get through the winter until spring, business would pick up. Well, when the Androscoggin mill was built, that became year-round. We didn't have layoffs. The business they were doing was full-time all the time, and that's what was an advantage of going up there. You had a better-looking future. I have a daughter. She only worked in the mill one summer. She was going to college. She knew there was no place she wanted to ever be, but it's not for everybody. I mean, working on paper machines is hot, a lot of moving machinery. Some people didn't like it. They couldn't stand having all these things moving around them, made them too nervous. But somewhere else, they do great. So, want like mechanical, I guess. Well, I'm not so sure what was the center. It used to be way back. But I think it got away from that a little bit. It was still the best paying jobs in the area, and the community did support them. Because I remember when it was going to add the number 3 machine up there, they'd go through all the environmental stuff. Well, an awful lot of people in the community went to Augusta at the hearings to support them for that, because it meant job, meant money, and it was impressive. I mean, the environmental people even had to admit they're impressive that so many people from the town would turn out in support of it. So they had the support.
What do you think about the future of the paper industry in Maine now?
I don't know. It doesn't look good. And I don't really understand why, in a way. You've got the resource. You've got the people. I don't understand some of it. It's not all foreign imports, like they say. I mean, but I don't know. They gotta keep changing. when I first started on paper machines, wallpaper was a big thing to produce. Well, now it's, how did anybody ever make that? But you have to keep changing with the times and what's the market is doing. Computers have changed a lot of demand for a lot of stuff. When I first started up there, some of the papers we make were business forms, because that's what the mill was really built for, business forms. Well, you had carbon and several colors of copy of paper. Well, geez, then they started coming out with carbonless paper. So that changed that market, and they had to adapt. And the printers were pen-fed printers, so you had to have paper that would go through these printers without jamming and it was fussy. Well, they don't do that stuff anymore. So you have to keep changing with the times, and don't look like they've done it around here. It's too bad, but I'd like to see them come up and something new, or some of the market keep it going. Even though I'm not working anymore, it still was good for the towns. For anybody that didn't go to college, it was a very good job. I mean, you made a good living out of it. You didn't have to have your wife working, mom did, but I mean, you could make a living on one person's wages. Benefits was as good as anybody's around. You just couldn't. The other alternative was shoe shops, which that wasn't. A lot of people worked in them, but they wasn't paying as well. So I'd like to see it come back, but doesn't look like it's going to.